little warm out here today. Thank you, everybody, for coming. If it's your first time to Freedom, welcome to Freedom Biker Church. Man, good to see you. Yeah. Man, we're just excited, and we're going to open up with a word of prayer. We've got some guys that are going to come around for those of you who come to Freedom. We want to thank you for your continual support through your tithes and offerings, and so they're going to come around with the boots if you're prepared to give this morning. If you're a guest here, thank you for coming. And so just enjoy your day today and the fellowship. And man, we're just thankful. This is week number 9. God has given us outdoors. Beautiful, beautiful weather. And man, it may rain this afternoon, but it's not raining now. Amen? Amen.
That's right.
Is anybody out there? Do y'all realize we're at the Outlet Mall beside of Highway 95 at Shelton's Harley Davidson talking about Jesus? Isn't that awesome? Hey, road dogs. Any road dogs out here?
Jesus!
Yeah, how about the biker baby? Man, come on, we can make some noise. This is all right, amen? Hey, let's go to the Lord in prayer, and then we're going to have some worship, and our boot bearers will come around, and then we'll see what God's got in store for us. Father, we thank you for this gorgeous day you've given us, for the beautiful sunshine, for another week of no rain and the opportunity to be outdoors. Father, we thank you for our guests that have rode in this morning. Keep everybody safe out today. Lord, we're just in awe of how good you are and how you rock our world all the time. Father, we stand out here just humbled by you in your sanctuary. We desire your presence to be in our midst this morning, Lord. Just whatever the need of everyone has come today, whether it's to be comforted, whether it's to be encouraged, whether it's to be challenged, whatever it is, Lord, we pray that you just come and you be you. Do only that which you can do. Lord, you're a true life changer. You're a friend, a brother that sticks closer than anything. You're our Heavenly Father. And Lord, today as we talk about putting you first in all things, help us to understand and realize that in this life, you created us for one thing, and that's our relationship and fellowship with you, and for us to exhibit that to this world. And Lord, we know more than ever this world needs to see what Jesus is all about. Amen. We thank you. Bless the offering now. Thank you for those, Lord, who continue to support and just are a part of this ministry. Thank you for everybody that's come. Open our ears and hearts, Father. We pray this in Jesus' name. And all God's people said?
No doubt.
No doubt. Let's get some worship on. What do we got over here, David? Oh, we're going to get louder with some Crowder. You all know we like Crowder, amen? Woo! He's our kind of people, huh? Oh, we're going bluegrass. That means you got to get up and dance and move and shake some. Got to work up a sweat. Crank it up, David. We can't hear that.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning again. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Isn't this gorgeous? Beautiful day. All the people hanging outside. It's hot, but they're all out here to hear the word. Isn't it fabulous? Hello, Pop.
Hey, praise God.
Woohoo! Look at all the motorboaters. Woohoo!
Thank you, God. I see the light.
Good morning. Good morning. Hi, ladies.
Oh, I ducked, but I thought we were
song for Freedom Bike and Cherish. So if it's your first time here, man, we'd like to just play it for you and get us all in the right frame of mind. Amen?
Amen.
Come on, it's all about being free. What the sun sets free is free indeed. So let's play a little Freedom. Come on.
Got that higher.
good to see you. And again, fresh water, free water, and we've got more water coming. Always better to have more. Amen. We needed the Lord to multiply the water like he did the fish and the loaves. So we sent Eric to the store to do the Lord's work and multiply. But, man, so glad you're here today. And if you have yet to get one of these cards, where's Mary at?
Over here.
Mary is passing these cards out to everybody. That would be Mary.
I ain't get one.
Hey, if you ain't got one, raise your hand.
Mary, you've been slack.
Mary, how are Leo? He's right here beside you. He ain't got nothing to do. If you ain't got a card, hold your hand up. So if you look at the card, it'll say on the front of it, it'll say Discover Freedom at our new location. Woo! Yeah. We've been sharing over the past few weeks, and we just didn't want to get ahead of God and what God was doing. And so, as you know, we had our last service week before last at our other facilities, and we had been at for 6 years. We'd really been praying that God would just, man, he'd been putting on our hearts for a couple of years to really be good stewards and be about the community and not just about a building or about having this church location. And Guy Road was a great place. We've enjoyed it, made a lot of relationships. A lot of people came to know the Lord there. A lot of people got hooked up there.
Amen.
Yeah. And praise the Lord, man, we took a skating rink and converted it into a house of worship. And it continues to be a house of worship today as another church is meeting there and having their worship. And so we had just been praying, and God had put a place in our path that would allow us to be able to not just rent it, not lease it, but to actually own it outright. So I can say today that Freedom Biker Church has not a church, but a homestead. Woo-hoo! Because you know, Freedom, we talk about this all the time, you're the church, right?
That's right.
The church is those who know and believe and have committed their lives to Jesus Christ, and we're the church. It's not about a building or a place. I mean, think about it this morning. This morning, who would have thought Shelton's Harley-Davidson would be a church? Some of y'all probably told some people, hey, I'm going to go to church this morning at Shelton's Harley-Davidson. Think about that. Are we having church this morning, church?
Amen.
I mean, come on, what is church? Well, it's having a relationship with Jesus. It's coming together as a family, and it's being able to just worship him. And thank God we can still do that in America. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah. Thank God we can. Thank the Lord for our freedoms as we celebrate the birthday of our country. But we celebrate more than anything the birth and freedom that we can have through Jesus Christ. And so God's given us a great homestead. And what's so cool about a homestead, if you look up the definition of homestead, it's a home surrounded by land occupied by a family. Isn't that awesome? A home surrounded by land that's occupied by a family. I think, man, that's the best description of what a place that we hang out and gather at should be, instead of, hey, I'm going to church on Sunday, or we got the church over here, because we know we're the church. Wherever you go this week, man, you're taking Jesus with you. You're the church. You're the embodiment. You're the exhibit, the example of Jesus Christ, church. And so we get to carry the church wherever we go. We get to share that faith that we have in our living Lord and Savior. And so this morning, we're out here at Shelton's Harley-Davidson preaching to the world. I love it, man. Woo! Wave, and everybody goes by on 95. Just give them a wave. Look at that. Isn't that awesome? So it doesn't matter where we're at, but, man, what's cool is to have a place that you can take your shoes off and hang up your helmet in the evening time, and a place you can call home. And so God has given us a place. So if you got one of these cards, if you look on the back of it, Freedom Biker Church Clayton has moved to 669, and listen, don't fault me, this is the most horrible road name in the world. Horrible, Eric.
And we're going to have to put in for a name change.
I can't say it, I won't say it. It's on this thing here. Tar Heel Road, Eric. That's horrible. Doesn't God have a sense of humor? Come on. Tar Heel Road, y'all. 669 Tar Heel Road in Benson. Man, I tell you, it's really cool because I shared a little bit over the past few weeks, about how God kind of brought this place into our path. And then we just prayed through it and asked God to show us. And as we talked about in Proverbs 3, trust in the Lord. Don't try to be wise in your own eyes. Don't lean to your own understanding. But just trust Him and watch Him open doors or close doors. And, man, we had been looking since September when we shared with the church last year about praying about selling the church and being able to purchase something with the equity to be debt-free. And God brought this property along. And, man, I'm telling you, it's 10 acres of beautifulness. We've got a 7,200-square-foot building with 5 draw doors on it. This is going to be, man, it's awesome. We can open the doors. We can hang out. We've got other buildings and facilities. And so something I want to offer you, I know some of y'all are off tomorrow because of the 4th. If you are off tomorrow and you'd like to come out and see the location and work a little bit, bring your work clothes. Don't bring your visiting clothes. Come on out tomorrow at 9 o'clock. We're going to meet out there and we're going to be working some. We spent this past week kind of cleaning up around there a little bit so it wouldn't be such a hazard when we came out there together. There's a lot of stuff everywhere, and we've had some folks come out and just help us get things kind of organized and clean the landscape up a little bit. And so tomorrow at 9 o'clock, some of us will be out there. We do need some hands. We got some stuff to move and things to do. It's pretty easy. So if you'd like to come and see it, just come on out. If you can't come tomorrow, here's a cool thing. Next Sunday morning, we're going to be meeting there and having our worship rally there. Next Sunday morning. So next Sunday, make sure you take this with you. So you wake up next Sunday and go, where's the church at today? 669 Tar Heel Road. In Benson, North Carolina, man. We'll start hanging out at 10 o'clock like we do, and the rally will start at 11 o'clock. And we're excited, man. It's a great thing. It's a great place. And, you know, we've been talking the last, this whole year, but the last few weeks about what it means to have clarity. Our whole, the whole thing that God put on our hearts this year was about 2020 vision, how to see through the lens and the eyes of the Lord. Man, to really seriously have God directing our steps, directing our paths. And, man, you know, we could not have had a better test than what we've had here in 2020. I mean, starting the whole year out with the whole COVID thing and all this stuff going on, and then we've had the latest stuff and riots and stuff, and people looking at things in all kinds of different ways. And for us, the most important thing as a church, as a body of believers, is to be able to see things how God sees it. How do we navigate through this? And we talked about, and we've been talking about as a church, to have clarity, to be able to know or see how God sees things, to know how we need to act. There's an old saying, WWJD, right? What would Jesus do, right? Right? Some of y'all have heard that. What would Jesus do? This is kind of funny because some folks think this is like something new or it's been around for a few years. Y'all know I share that I love to read Oswald Chambers, just a great mind, a great blessing God used. And so years ago, Oswald wrote a devotional, and it was simply this. Jesus saved us. God's sent His Son to die for us, to have a relationship with us, so that we're not becoming Jesus. We're not Jesus. Jesus was God in human flesh. He was something that no one else can be. And He did something that no one else could do. We are to trust and believe in Him and commit our lives to Him to have a relationship. And then it's through what Jesus did that we can have a relationship with God, right? He's the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through Him. And so we enter this relationship with this commitment. And Oswald said this, and I said, it's just amazing. This many years ago, but what's the old saying? If it's true, it's not new. If it's new, it's not true, right? So it's been around forever. Oswald said a lot of times we like to ask, well, what would Jesus do? And it's not what would Jesus do, but what would Jesus have me to do in this situation or in this circumstance? How would Jesus want us to respond or to react in certain situations or circumstances? Maybe today you're going through something in life and you're kind of at a big question mark. You're not really sure which way to turn or which way to go, or maybe there's some unanswered questions, or maybe just there's some uneasiness or some lack of peace or something in your life. And sometimes, you know, we like to think that, man, we'll just give our life to the Lord. You know, we hear preachers and people say, everything's going to be okay. It's going to be great. Everything's going to be wonderful. Wonderful. Man, well, it will be. Amen?
Amen.
It will be. And it's amazing how things work out when we trust the Lord. And the biggest thing is this, though. We've got to have an understanding and clarity to see that God's leading and doing something and be able to trust Him with it. Not try to handle on ourselves or worry or wonder about what's going to happen or how we're going to get through it. And that starts with a commitment to Him and then living with Jesus. Learning how to trust Him. Learning how to treasure what's real treasure. Man, learning how to exhibit a life that's honoring and a life that God's called us to. And then if you got your Bibles this morning, because I don't know if you got Wi-Fi out here or an app, but if you got your Bibles, turn to Matthew chapter 6. Matthew chapter 6. Oh, we got to start going to old school, everybody. Got to start bringing them paperbacks. We've got some Freedom Bibles over here, but it's very small print. If you got good eyes, you can read it. Matthew chapter 6. So if you don't have your Bibles, just listen. I'll read it to you, this portion here. Matthew chapter 6, starting at verse 25. I read a little bit of this last week if you were up at Tobacco Road. And again, thank you for coming out and supporting Tobacco Road and Shelton's this morning. We're so just privileged to be here. So Matthew chapter 6, verse 25. Therefore, I tell you, the Lord says, do not be anxious about your life. Don't be anxious about your life. What you'll eat or what you will drink, or about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more than food and the body more than clothing? Think about that. Sometimes, man, it's easy in this world to get very materialistic, and all we think about is, man, what we've got or what we wish we had. But you and I know as well, and probably better than a lot of folks, that, man, when we talk about the riding a motorcycle, right? That whole thing's about riding a motorcycle. Amen?
Amen.
I mean, what's the best? Look, y'all that rode in this morning, me and Charlene came in, we jumped out on 70, we came from Clayton up here. You know, the best thing about it was cool, there was a nice breeze. Man, we loved riding the motorcycle in this morning. Right now, it's sitting right there in the hot sun, that seat's cooking. It's gonna be hot on my honey when I get ready to get on it. You know, this is not the fun part of motorcycling. The fun part of motorcycling is riding, amen?
Amen?
Man, we can get so sidetracked sometimes in life about all these things that are going on or things that maybe not are happening the way we want to or what we have or what we wish we had that we miss what the real thing or the real importance of life is. It's not about food or the clothing. It's about what God's doing in our lives. So verse 28, he says this, verse 26, look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not more valuable than they? And which of you, by being anxious, can add a single hour to his span of life? Nobody out here has control over their lives in such a way that you can add a moment to it. Sitting here this morning, every one of us here this morning, we're sitting here by the pure grace of God.
Amen?
Amen?
Yeah.
I mean, it's just because God's allowing us to be here this morning. So think about that. He's given you an opportunity. He's given you an opportunity to make a decision or to think about something or to listen and to see what He's saying to us this morning. It's a gift from God. We can't add to our time on this earth. And so why are you anxious about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon, and you know, I talk about reading Proverbs all the time. Solomon, his one thing he asked from the Lord was wisdom, the wisest man ever. And all of his glory was not arrayed, was not clothed like any of these. The pure flowers of the earth, Jesus says, are clothed better than Solomon was. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which today is alive and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will He not much more clothe you? Right? And church, listen, God will take care of us if we'll just trust Him. if we don't try to get ahead of him, if we're not leaning to what makes what we think makes sense or our wisdom, this whole situation with what God's done through freedom since the day we started freedom 14 years ago to right now is absolutely just a walk of faith and an exhibit of God's greatness. You realize that next Sunday, which we're going to be meeting where?
Duke Road.
Duke Road. 669 Woodpeck Lane. 669
Tar Heel Road.
We're going to be meeting it next Sunday. I don't know if you know this, but July the 9th, 2006, Freedom Bible Church was started. Next Sunday is going to be our 14th anniversary.
Woo-hoo!
Is that not crazy? I mean, you can't make that stuff up. How in the world could we have known somebody was going to buy a building and we had to rush to get out of it and then open up another building that was going through all kinds of judgment, court stuff that we had to wait on, that God would give us the opportunity to be able to be in the building for the first time on our anniversary of 14 years.
That's all God right there.
Oh, that's lucky, preacher.
That's all God right there.
Man, that's all God right there. Who said that? Sheila? You mean you excited about being in the new home next week?
I'm sorry.
Yeah, she is.
You're going to love it. Hey, you got saved, you got married, but you'll get buried somewhere else.
In the backyard.
But we hope it's no worse in no time soon. It's going to be awesome. We can't make this up, man, when we just trust God and we see. So don't be considered as Jesus was challenging the disciples and those around him by saying, man, you have little faith. He says, listen, therefore, do not be anxious saying, what shall we eat? What shall we drink? Or what shall we wear?
Hot dogs.
Hot dogs. That's what you'll be eating if you want to. Water. We've got some. Man, listen. Hey, God will provide those things in our life. And I can tell you just from, man, just from a fact of mine and Charlene's life and so many of you here today, you know exactly what I'm talking about, how God sees us through situations and we feel like we're totally out of control. We have no clue how to get through it or how we're going to get through it. Then God walks us right through it. And that is just an exhibit of God's grace and his goodness and his love. And the cool thing is we don't have to be anxious through it. You know, man, it's so much more difficult. I know in my life, I've been saved for a long time, but I remember back before I was saved how it was much more difficult not really knowing. Growing up in church and hearing about Jesus and hearing someone talk about Jesus and having a mom that loved the Lord and got up every morning and prayed and did devotion and prayed for her kids and stuff and drug us to church until we were old enough that we could do what we wanted to do. And, you know, having that was really important, really good, because it set something in my life. But it wasn't until I actually accepted Christ as my own personal Savior that I began to experience it. So it's kind of like, man, watching people ride by on a motorcycle and thinking, man, I sure would like to get one of those and try that one time. Right? Amen? Because you're watching all these people riding. Well, all you got to do is go ask anybody that rode in this morning. They'll be like, man, it was nice. It was awesome. Where's our folks that rode in from Bellevue at?
Beulahville,
that's right, Beulahville. Hour and a half away, man. That's awesome. Good ride this morning. Might be a little warmer going back. That's all right. It's all downhill from here. Man, it's such a... Look, hey, this morning, if you've never rode a motorcycle, you've never had a better opportunity, because there's a bunch of them right in there for sale. Amen? And you can experience it today. If you never accepted Jesus Christ, your Lord and Savior, and you really don't know for sure what it's like to walk with a God who created everything, who sustains everything, everything exists because of him, man, today you can also experience that. Amen? It's real easy. I mean, as soon as I get through in just a second, man, we'll pray. And then if you'd like to talk to somebody about Jesus or have someone pray with you, you can come right up here and we'll get together and, man, we'll knock it out when we do it. This is what Jesus finished saying here. I know it's hot. Hang with me for just a second. So he says, don't worry about that. He says the Gentiles, those who didn't believe, they sought after all these signs,
And your Heavenly Father knows that you need all of them. God knows what we need. He created us. He knows. Right? But, verse 33, and this is what I shared last week. But, seek first the kingdom of God. Seek first the kingdom of God. When you think about the kingdom of God, I'm going to talk about this a little bit later on, a few weeks down the road here. But when you think about the kingdom of God, I want you to think about this. In fact, go back in your Bible, maybe get on Google and just research the kingdom of God. Jesus said to repent, to turn to Him, and to seek the kingdom. Many times Jesus talked about when He was here on earth, right? God in human flesh, that the kingdom of God was at hand. When you think about when He says, seek first the kingdom of God, He's literally basically talking about His own self. Seek the things of God. Seek His Son. Jesus would multiple times talk about, here the kingdom of God is in your midst. Seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things, the things of life that He knows we need, will be added to you. Therefore, do not be anxious. Don't be anxious about tomorrow, for tomorrow will be anxious for itself. Sufficient for today is its own trouble. Man, committing our lives to the Lord, living with Jesus, and learning how we do that by trusting Him, by realizing what's really important in life, leads us to what we started talking about last week, and that's the arrangement of things in our life. I was sharing last week at Tobacco Road that think about how is your life arranged. I want you to think about that for just a few minutes. Is how, what's really the most important thing in our life? What's the most important thing in your life? You know, me and Charlene moved into a tiny house, and I've shared some horror stories, and I've got a lot more horror stories to share. But one of the things we had to learn real quick in that tiny house was arrangement. Because in your regular house, when we lived in sticks and bricks, well, stuff on the counter, you didn't have to worry about taking off the counter every time you went to move. You didn't have to worry about what you put in the shelf. Mac, I could shove all kinds of stuff in the cabinets. Put stuff under the cabinet, stick things here and there. A tiny house, though, if y'all ever lived in a tiny house or traveled in an RV, then you know what you've got to do before you leave is you got to take everything off the countertop. You got to make sure everything in those drawers and those cabinets is packed right, because we'd always have kind of this game we'd play every time we'd get somewhere, right, honey? She'd open the door, I'd open the door, and she'd get ready to catch. Because, man, stuff is going to come flying out. And sometimes when we first started, we make the mistake of walking there and just opening the cabinet door. And all of a sudden, man, those high cabinets, you could get knocked out with pots and pans and all kinds of junk come flying out of there. You had to watch it. It's really important how you arrange stuff in there. You know, when you think about a life of Jesus Christ, man, I want you to think this morning about God says He already knows that we have need of things in life. We have need of food. We have need of water, right? We have need of clothes and a roof over our head. And we have needs of things in our life. But what we got to make sure is that we realize and remember that God already knows that. And if He already knows it and He'll already provide it for us, then so what should be the most important thing that sits at the top of the arrangement? There's a thing I learned a long time ago as a kid in vacation Bible school. Some of y'all may. How many of y'all have ever been to vacation Bible school? Let me see your hands. Oh, yeah. Yeah, a lot of y'all learned. So there was something they told us about living for the Lord, and there was a simple little acrostic acronym. What's your one, Debbie? I think it's an acronym, right? For the word joy. Has anybody ever heard that? If you really want joy in life, this is what you got to do. This is how you have to arrange things in your life. J, joy. Jesus first, right? Seek ye first the kingdom of God. Jesus. O, others. Others second. The Bible always talks about us putting others before ourselves, right? Even those that we consider our enemies. Man, that's hard sometimes. Put others first. Then what do you guess the Y stands for? Anybody?
Yourself.
Yourself. Yourself. Well, come on, let's be real honest for just a minute, because I will. To me, that's hard sometimes. Because even though I may be the pastor and we're doing things for the Lord. Eric, you know, we work hard. You guys been doing stuff out there for the Lord. But sometimes it's easy for us to get up and think, what do we have to do today? Right? And if we're not careful, we start focusing on what we've got to do because we feel like we're doing it for the Lord. And all of a sudden, we may absolutely miss what God's got intended for us today because we're so focused on what we think we need to do for Him. Man, it's easy to put ourselves and our plans and our thoughts and things in our lives before Jesus and even before others. But what Jesus says is simply this. In our lives, if you're here today and you call yourself a Christian, you know Jesus is your Savior, then He absolutely has to be the first thing in your life. He has to be arranged first. Seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness. We'll talk about that a little more later on. But seek first Jesus. But I tell you, folks, it's easy, even as a Christian, to get things reversed to where we start thinking about ourselves and what we want to accomplish or what we want to do. And I can tell you, man, you know, I've shared, it's been 30 years we've been doing this, Charlene, right? And Freedom Bible Church, God has taught us more in the last 14 than any. And so much of it is this, patience. Man, when we went into the bowling alley, I tell you, man, a lot of folks killed themselves for about 2 months working hard to make a nice church for people to come to. And we totally missed it. Not that we didn't make a great place, not that it wasn't good, but we were working really hard on a building to make a building something that it'll never be. A building will never be the church. The church is us. 669 Tar Heel Road is the homestead, folks. That Freedom Biker Church, the family, is going to hang out in. And everybody that wants to, man, is welcome to come. You're welcome to come. You're welcome to hang out. And hopefully one day we'll have a place where you can rest your weary soul at night and get some rest, stay a few days while you're on your journey, and just be open to the community that God's called us to. Man, we have an opportunity to do everything God called us to from the day one back in July 2006. To be everything God's called us to be. A brotherhood of bikers bound by a faith relationship in Jesus. A passion and love for the motorcycle and the open road. A real bond, a real brotherhood. And it's not about a building, it's about a family. And we as a family got to make sure that we put Jesus first. Amen?
Amen.
Jesus, others, and then yourselves. Hey, will you pray with me real quick? We're keeping it short this morning because it is hot up here. And I know it's hot out there. I can't tell you how humbled I am and how appreciative I am of everybody that's come this morning. Lord, we love you. I pray that you continue to challenge, speak to our hearts as a family, as a body of believers. We pray that you help us always in all we do arrange you first in our lives, that we seek you first, that we trust you, that we're not anxious about the little things, because that's exactly what Satan loves to do. That's exactly what this world would do, was get us sidetracked and get us focused on everything but what you're doing. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity, and again for Shelton and for Sharon opening their doors today. Bless them this day. May it be a over and above blessed day. For holding back the rain one more Sunday. For giving us a place we can call home. God, I could go on and on. Lord, you're so good to us. I pray this morning for anyone here that just has some questions. Maybe he's not really sure. Am I missing something in my life? Lord, if they would come today, talk to us. Or just let us pray with them. Father, I know we got some folks that are in the hospital. We got some folks who have been sick or going through some things and some with some surgeries coming up. And we just pray for our family. We know that you're God who knows all things. And so, Lord, just give us the wisdom we need to have as we just minister to each other. Thank you for the freedom of the open road, Lord. And most of all, thank you for the freedom of what the Son sets free is free indeed. God, help us to keep you first, others second, and ourselves last. This life's not about us. It's about what you created us to do and be, and how we can exhibit your goodness and your grace to others. Lord, we love you and we thank you. Bless the food, Father. And thank you for the preparers and for the opportunity to be here together to enjoy it. Lord, we pray this in Jesus' name. And all God's people said,
no doubt.
No doubt, man, no doubt. Hey, thank you for coming. Make sure you get a hot dog out there on the side of the building. Go in, and they're going to be opening up the shop there in just a little bit. New motorcycles readily available. And next week, 669 Tar Heel Road, 10 o'clock, we'll be hanging out. Come up and join us, man. Tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock, if you're off, you want to come out and work a little bit, come out and hang out with us. Amen. Hey, I want to thank everybody from Freedom, our home team, and everybody's helped bring out the grills and the trailers the last few weeks and just do all this work. Man, thank you guys so much. We love you. And God bless you. Have a great day. Be safe today. If you need anybody to talk to or pray with, come on up.
Let me take the mic, or just all right. Till next week, y'all.